I know how it feels to feel empty and not want to even live anymore.
I can hear my doctor's voice vividly.
He said, your muscle is wasting away chronically and we don't know the cause. And you may be in a wheelchair at 30. I felt weak, I felt helpless, I felt worthless, I felt ugly.
To my channel Godiva Beauty. If it's your first time here, hi, I'm Startasia. I'm a full specialist beautician and a beauty vlogger on YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram. Check me out at Godiva Beauty. That's G-O-D-I-E-V-A and then beauty. Yes, the I is before the E, like your vowels, as you guys know if y'all are on my channel. But I just wanted to come to you guys today with a couple of questions that were on my heart. Are you a person that's experiencing hardships in life and you don't know how to navigate them? Are you a person who's been diagnosed with a disease, depression, struggling with an addiction? Someone who feels like you're in this world alone or no one understands you truly, who you really are? Well, if that's you, girl, boy, do I have a word for you today. And I promise you, I'm gonna bless you, okay? So stay tuned. I can hear my doctor's voice vividly. We got your test results back, and your CPK blood level is 9,300 when normal is 29 to 143. The adelase in my blood was at 61.9. Normal would be less than 8.1. CPK and adelase leaks into your blood when you have muscle wasting. He said, your muscle is wasting away chronically and we don't know the cause. There's no way for you to get the muscle that you've lost back, and you may be in a wheelchair at 30. We've done all the testing we can, and I suggest you go to UF for further testing. I did. I ended up going to UF for further testing, and no one had an answer for me of what exactly was wasting away my muscle. They chop it up to genetics. I just didn't understand, like, why was this happening to me? I felt robbed of my future, of everything that I wanted, everything that I worked towards was just taken away from me. I felt weak, I felt helpless, I felt worthless, I felt ugly. I feel that for somebody. I don't know what your situation is, I don't know what you're going through, whether it's depression, whether it's a breakup, whether it's low self-esteem. I feel this for you because I felt it for me. If you were to look me up on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, you would never know that I'm struggling with something. I never speak about it. And I haven't. It's been 2 years. You would think I'm just leveling up, levitating towards my purpose, which is I am. I am. But Jesus put a little special tweak on me. He put a little special, unique tweak towards me that I couldn't see the beauty in at first. But I'm still accepting, I'm still trying to work past, and it's not easy. We can't allow what seems like devastation and punishment at that moment define our future. Okay guys, so I'm gonna tell you guys a story, right? And just stay with me, I promise I'm gonna bless you. Now, there's a story that my mom always tell me about that old goat. And I'm a little sketchy with the story, so if I get it wrong, mom, please correct me in the comments. But this is a story that she really stresses to me and tries to apply in all aspects. There was a farmer, and he had multiple goats that he would let go graze the grass. And then when he brought them in that day, he noticed that one of his goats were missing. So he went and looked around on his farm looking for this goat, just wondering where his goat went. So he noticed that there was this old well that the goat had fell down. The farmer was upset. He was like, wow, I just lost my goat. He said, you know what? Let me at least give it its proper burial. So the farmer went and got a shovel. He came back and he started shoveling the dirt into the well just to bury his goat the right way. What that old goat was doing behind the scenes, nobody saw.
And I kind of take that as what God is doing under the well in your life. Nobody sees. You can't even see. Every time the farmer shovels some dirt on the goat's back, it will shake it off and pack it under its feet. And I find that so symbolic because you can kind of apply that to your life. Some of us are in the position of that old goat. I don't think that old goat knew when he was gonna get out that well. I don't think he knew if he was gonna get out of that well, but I believe that that old goat just moved with action and faith. This story is a pure example of the fact that we cannot let hardships in life stop us or set us back. When life is covering you with dirt, when life tries to bury you alive, I want you to fight back. I want you to speak life into yourself and know that every struggle in your life is there for Jesus to make miracles. That old goat shook that dirt off his back and packed it under his feet. He didn't give up. He didn't question. He moved with action and he moved with faith. And that's the way you have to move with life. That's the only way that we're going to really go through this thing. We can't constantly be losing ourselves every time something goes wrong, guys. Sometimes, guys, I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know if I'm doing the right thing. I've just been following my intuition and following God's voice, following the beat of his drum, just letting him take the lead and surrendering to him. My main purpose is to touch the heart of a young boy or girl going through something similar to me. You're going through depression, you're going through anxiety issues, bad relationship, drug addiction. I know that he brought me here for me to say something that you already knew, and it gives you this aha moment and you're like, wow, I felt the same way. I just needed someone to say it. I want to be that for you. I want you to see a light in me that shines a light on you, and then you see that you have that light in you too. I'm not trying to impose my religion on anyone, but this is just personally what works for me, and I believe that the people that are meant to be around me will gravitate towards me naturally. Yeah, I don't want to be on here for the likes. I don't want to be on here for the views. I just want to be on here for the glory of God. Truly. Everything I post, everything I say, everything I do, I want it to be from a natural place. A place where God is confirming. I've been waiting for God to tell me to speak. And I feel like the world's ready for me. I'm not going to hide my struggles anymore. Everything's front and center. This is what I'm dealing with, and I'm my own competition. I don't compete with anyone. I know for a fact that Jesus has a people assigned to me, a people that needs me to be myself unapologetically. When you have self-doubt, when you have fear, when you have anxiety, when you feel like you can't take life anymore, I want you to shake it off and pack it under your feet. That old goat rose to the top of that well that day. Hallelujah. Okay. That old goat rose to the top, but I think y'all are missing it. Some of us can relate to this farmer also. Had that farmer not gave up hope, had he decided not to bury his goat alive, God would have never been able to perform a miracle in his life. God would have never been able to get that old goat to the top of that well. Where there's darkness, there's light. And I will forever preach that to you guys. That old goat was being buried just to be set free. That's with a lot of us. I had to go and take on a new identity. That everything is the way it's supposed to be. A lot of the things we stress about, if we had control over them, we wouldn't be stressing, would we? But we find ourselves stressing over things we can't control. Why are we doing that to ourselves? I'm going to get more into that later in the video. Don't worry, guys. Don't worry. I'm going to bless you. I'm going to bless you. If you're not blessed already, I'm going to bless you. There's a quote that I love that says, you don't inspire others by being perfect. You inspire them by how you deal with those imperfections. You inspire them by doing the best you can every single day. I feel that for you. I feel that for us on a deeper level. I'm not going to sit here and say I'm in the best place with my health, but this step right here is what was holding me back. I was being selfish and keeping my truth from the world, hiding the very things that makes me uniquely Startasia. The next 2 years after my diagnosis, I did go through depression. I kind of fell off the face of earth, but I'm here. And to think that I wanted to leave the face of this earth, the world's dirt was covering me. It was suffocating me. Even though I had some doubt, I kept moving. It was action. It was faith like that old goat when he shook it off his back and packed it under his feet. I'm in partnership with God, and that's one of the newest things that I'm doing different in my life. And there's a fire in me that's gonna set this earth on flames. I'm not stopping until somebody feels the fire burning inside of me. Until I light you on fire, and then we're on fire, and then we're setting this world on fire. I have a purpose. You're still here. You have a purpose. We have a purpose. There's a battle going on inside of you. You don't know what's going on, but there's a battle going on inside of you, and it's time for you to shake it off your back and pack it under your feet. It's now May 2019. My vision is more vivid than ever before, and my faith is stronger than it's ever been in my life. And I want you guys to come through this journey with me. I told y'all before, I ain't chasing likes, I ain't chasing views, I'm chasing souls. I'm chasing true connections with people who genuinely believe what I believe. I feel like Jesus wanted me to share it. Jesus is telling me that I'm beautiful, and he's hyping me up, and he's getting me on levels higher than I thought I could go. So I'm not afraid anymore. I don't really care what people think about me. You can judge me. You can tell me I'm faking. You can tell me I'm lying. I'm not going to argue with you. Take it up with Jesus. I have 5 steps that I feel would really help you. The first one is focus on what you can control. I know how it feels to feel empty and not want to even live anymore. When the doctor told me I was gonna be in a wheelchair, I just thought that was the end of life. I obsessed over it for 2 years, and all I did was manifest that. So remember that where your attention goes, energy flows. That's the quote I was looking for. So make sure that you're doing the best you can to be intentional with your thoughts and what you're focusing your time on. And right now we've got some things going on where we need to stay focused, and we need to get out of the hole that we're in and move to the next level. Step 2, accept who you are and where you are. When I was diagnosed, I couldn't accept it. I couldn't believe it. I couldn't understand. And I realized that it's bigger than me, and Jesus uses people for his purpose. And I'm no longer fighting it anymore. I see it as such a blessing that he would choose me to elevate me on that level. Once you accept it, you can see the light in it. You can see the beauty in it. And once you see where you are, you can build from there. If you never accept where you are and what you're dealing with, you never acknowledge anything, then nothing's ever gonna get solved. Remember that. Step 3, forgive yourself for what got you there. Now, sometimes we can be our worst enemies. Sometimes we're literally working against ourselves as we speak, sometimes with some habits that we're trying to break. Yes, where we are right now is a product of what we've been doing for the past 5-6 years, correct? Understand that, you didn't know. Give yourself the benefit of the doubt. Now, once your mind has been stretched, which is what I came here to do, I came here to stretch your mind. Once your mind has been stretched, now you can never go back. So as long as you choose to stay on the same energy level that you're on, whether that's low or high, just know that you did it. And if you change your situation, just know that you did it. You know now, forgive yourself, and learn from it. Move on. Step 4, think about what you can gain or learn from the situation. Mine, for example, I can only get finer, you know what I mean? Like, I can only get thicker, I can only get stronger, my body can only get shaped out more better, like I can only fall more in love with myself. I used to think it was such a bad thing, but it just pushes me to go in the gym harder. I'll feel good, my body feels good, I'll get stronger, I feel accomplished. What better blessing than that? Step 5, talk to someone, guys. I actually have a support group that I'm actually kicking off in July of this year. It's called Empower Herstory Sisters. And we're just gonna be a group of women that empower each other and talk to each other. And the main purpose for that was because I knew that there was a need for it. When I went through this, I didn't have anyone to talk to. I kind of only had the people around me. And some of the people around me were telling me, oh no, you're just fat. You just need to lose weight. There's nothing wrong with you. To me, everyone's draining me, telling me what's wrong with me. And even though I knew what I felt, I was numb. I couldn't feel myself anymore. Once I decided to pull from a different source, when I decided to go into partnership with God, that was just like a different level. That was like the level up of level up. And I know for a fact that that's gonna be the difference between this time and any other time. Sometimes we feel like nobody understands us because of what we're going through, which is what I felt. I felt like no one understood me. I always found myself defending myself. I mean, I had an encounter with the homegirl. I was just telling her about it, and she acknowledged it like no one had ever acknowledged it. I had this muscular situation diagnosed for a year at that point. I was just now being encountered by someone who acknowledged where I was in life, and it was like, wow, you see me. And I know the power of seeing people. I know the power of words, of support. I know the power of having a friend. If you want to join my support group and actually be able to attend a meeting, you can. I'm on Facebook. Check me out at Godiva Beauty. The support group is located on my page so that you'll be able to kind of request to be in it. If you're really just someone out here and you need some love and you need a friend close to you, no matter what you're going through, I'm here for you. God's here for you. We're here for you. And you just come whenever you need me, whenever you need some light. Change your mindset and your limiting beliefs. I am a firm believer. Where the mind goes is where the body follows. Remember that how you're thinking is how you're gonna be physically. You're overeating because you're depressed and you're just binging on things, mentally binging. Do understand that that's going to reflect physically in your life. We have to remember to always be intentional and live your life intentionally. Focus on growing mentally, focus on feeding our souls, and focus on rewriting some things, because some of the things are just not adding up anymore. Folks, saying things like that into the earth is what you're going to put out into the earth, and that's what's going to come back to you. So just be mindful of your limiting beliefs. And those are all the tips that I think will help, guys. This is only the first of its kind. I'm going to make more videos for you. If there's something you're struggling with, comment down below, and I will definitely make a video for you, or inbox me. If you want to be added to my support group, just let me know by inbox. Check out my Instagram at Godiva Beauty for daily quotes. I'm spreading love all 2019. Y'all already know that. You can hop on this trip or not. Either way, we're giving God the glory regardless. I won't stop until I go from glory to glory to glory to glory. Remember, shake it off and pack it under your feet. Move with action and faith. Don't focus on what you can't control. Accept who you are, where you are. Love who you are, because I love you. Forgive yourself for what got you in that place. Think about what you can gain or learn from the experience. Talk to someone, join a support group, message me, join my Empower Her Story Sisters. Let's empower each other. Change your mindset and your limiting beliefs. And I know that you guys can do this. I see it for me. I can see it for you. It's all for us. I believe that nobody can block my blessings. And I just want to pray for you real quick. If you could close your eyes and lift your hands for me. It's getting dark, but I'm not stopping until I get this message across. Hallelujah. I want you to raise your hands to the sky, because that's where our power comes from. Once again, if you're not a religious, spiritual person, you can ignore all this and just take my tips. But Jesus, I want you to make some things happen in their life. I feel like there's some people out there like that old goat struggling with some things right now. And you're under the surface, and you're making a way, and you're giving hope, and you're surprising us. You're showing us miracles. The farmer thought it was a miracle that that old goat got up to the top of that well. He thought he was burying him alive just to say him free. I want you to set us free. This fire burning inside, this battle going on inside, Jesus, we cannot comfortably sit and not speak, Jesus. You're telling us to speak up. You're telling us to go for what we want. You're telling us to love ourselves and not let anyone or anything take that away from us. Give them your strength, your light, your love, your energy, your wisdom. Just pour into their life, Jesus. Allow us to pour into each other's lives. Allow some people to have that aha moment of, I knew that. I just needed to hear it, Jesus. I pray that you use me as a vessel for your word, Jesus, your light, all of you, none of me. Thank you. We love you. I love you guys. I'm gonna get off now. If this resonated in your heart, comment below, inbox me, let me know how you feel, or whatever it is that you want me to talk about or touch a topic on. I could probably bring some insight on your situation as well. I love you guys. Bye.